Hey guys, welcome back to my channel once more. I am Dipanjan. I hope you all guys are doing well. In my today's video, I am going to show you how to make paneer masala. So for that, I have already heated up the pan and now I am adding some soybean oil. So as the pan is already heated up, so oil will take only half minutes to get heated up finally. After that, I will be adding some cumin seeds or zira. When the cumin seeds will change its color, I will be adding some chopped onions. Now you can cut onions according to your convenience. I have sliced the onions and I will fry it until the onions turns a little soft and it changes color. Keep the flame on medium low so that the onions doesn't get burned. As the onions have become a little soft, now I will be adding some ginger garlic paste. Here you can also use grated gingers and garlic and some slit of green chilies. Now guys, why I have added them, because I will cook it until and unless the raw smell of the ginger garlic paste completely goes off, and ginger and green chilies give a very good taste to the dish. So you must add it together, and I will cook it until the raw taste of the ginger garlic goes off and the green chilies mixes well with the paste. After that, I will be adding some ground spices. So firstly, I will be adding Kashmiri red chili powder, coriander powder, turmeric powder. Now you can use turmeric powder, or you also do, if you don't want to use, you cannot use, you can skip this step. Next, I will be adding some cumin powder, and I will mix all the ground spices with the onions very well, and always keep the flame on low so that the spices doesn't get burned. After mixing them well, I will be adding some chopped tomatoes. At the same time, I will be adding salt. Now here I have add 1.5 teaspoon of salt. Now why I have added salt? Because mixing the salt with the tomatoes helps the tomatoes to get cooked very easily and in a rapid speed. So I will cook it. Guys, 4 minutes have passed and you can see that the tomatoes are completely cooked and it's leaving oil, and so it is cooked. Now I will be adding some chili flakes. Now you can also skip this step if you don't want to add chili flakes, as I have already added green chilies, Kashmiri red chili powder and chili flakes, so the spice content of the dish is already high. So mix it very well. Now after mixing them, I will be adding some paneer. Now you can also fry the paneers, but I have directly used them in the dish. You can also fry it, and I have cut the paneers into big cube size. Then I will be adding the paneer in the dish. Now guys, use soft hand so that the paneer doesn't break in the curry, and mix it very well with the curry. After mixing it very well, now I will be keeping it on low flame for 3 to 4 minutes. I am using a stopwatch, so I will start the stopwatch and I will keep it for 3 to 4 minutes so that the paneer get mixed with the curry. 4 minutes have passed guys, and you can see that the curry is beautiful looking. Next, I will be adding some pinches of garam masala and coriander leaves, and I will mix it very well. Now the main purpose of adding garam masala in the last part, because it gives a very good taste to the curry. And I will keep the gas off and I will keep it covered for 1/2 minute or 2 minutes so that the freshness of the coriander leaves get distributed in the curry. So guys, you can see that our paneer masala is completely ready to serve. So if you like my video, don't forget to like, share and comment, and hit the subscribe button so that you never miss an update from my channel.